Look for this logo for Honest Canadian Dairy.
So good morning, guys. Just had some quick breakfast, finished up with some barn chores. So anybody that's new to the channel, my name is Luke. If you're new here, please hit the subscribe button. If you're not new here and subscribed and have been watching my videos, I'm so sorry I haven't posted for like 2 months. It has just been crazy busy. Harvest, chopping corn, had 16, 18 hour days. I just couldn't do YouTube videos at the time. But now things are kind of settling down here, so I can start posting again. Hopefully post at least once a week, something like that. We'll see how things go around here yet. I got lots to show you of what I've been up to. Crazy things, we put some water beds into our barn. I got a lot of video of the past 2 months, so I'm gonna show you guys that after. But right now, we are here filling up the tractor and we're gonna go do some tillage. I guess my fun for the day is over in the tractor. Time to go haul some wheat now in the cold and freeze all day. Oh well. We got the truck all set up here in the auger. Letting it warm up for a few minutes and we're gonna start filling the truck and then head out. just pulling up to the elevator now. Looks like I'm gonna be stuck behind a B train for a little bit, but that's okay. So they got the big probe up there. They're gonna stick it inside the truck. They're gonna grab a sample. And then he's gonna pull forward and dump in the pit. Now later this evening, I got home for hauling grain, so I'm gonna show you guys these water beds we put in the barn. For those that have watched my channel from before in the past, you guys know that we have had deep bedded straw. This barn used to be a sand barn before we bought it. Once we bought it, we ripped all the sand out. Then we had deep bedded straw for a while, and we knew that was just gonna be temporary until we decided what we were gonna do. So then we decided we're gonna put water beds in, and we were gonna get it done before this winter, so we did it, and that's what we've been doing as we were chopping corn. So this kind of took like 3 weeks to do. Every Monday was a concrete pour, so we had to do the barn in three different sections. So what we ended up doing, we ended up ripping all these stall dividers out of the barn, so it would be easier for them to pour concrete. And then they poured the concrete, got everything ready, put the mats in, and then we put all the stall dividers back. So we did that just because it made the concrete guy's life a lot easier. They didn't have to work around all these stall dividers going in between them all. So we took them all out, opened everything up. They did their job quick, fast, easy. Same with the mats. The guys that came to install the mats, they did it within 6 hours. They're installed, filled with water. So each of these water beds are actually filled in a cell. So there's a cell in each stall, and every cell is filled with about 34 liters of water. So if you can see that, the jiggle there, that's the water inside the bed. So if we go on this side, you maybe see it better. And as you can probably tell behind me, there's a lot of cows laying down. These mats are extremely comfortable. There is 2 inch of foam underneath this water, so the cows are not actually laying on the water. It's kind of just there to disperse their weight a bit. They are laying on the foam. The water's there for extra comfort. So here's a cow laying down. You can see the cell there. Don't want to bugger too much. But yeah, these stalls are definitely the way to go if you're gonna be looking at putting stalls in. I think they're well worth the money. They're not very cheap. They are pretty expensive for what they are, in my opinion, but well worth it. Straw. We use about 80% less straw now than we did with deep bedded straw. Only because we're using way, way less straw. We only need a thin layer on top to keep the bed dry. I bring in straw about once maybe every week to a week and a half now. Before, I was bringing in straw every 4 days with the deep bedded straw. And I also bring in about half the amount now than I did before. So that's also a plus. That's less straw going to the lagoon, more liquid into the lagoon, and it's just way easier to mix up manure in the fall time when it's ready to haul it out. So with all that being said, I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. Please, please subscribe if you're not subscribed yet. I want to get this channel to 10,000 subscribers. Maybe by the end of the year, hopefully it's possible. You guys can make it possible. So thank you all for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Thanks.